You are my honey bun, sugar plum, pumpy umby umpkin. You're my sweetie pie.
I met Monte about almost 2 years ago. We met at the Adam auditions. And first thing he said to me was my tattoos, the Jason Voorhees tattoo. We became friends after that. Exchanged numbers and then just became friends really quick. And we just loved playing with each other. We were all into the same music and everything. And then after that, the tour had ended. I didn't really want to play with anyone else because I have a lot of respect for him. He's a great guitar player. And I'm excited he's getting to make this album. And I just want to help him in any way I can to get it done. Yeah. I have too much more.
Phenomenal singers. I mean, the best singers, you know, around. We're all doing this. There's a guy, Alan Lewis. He's on Broadway now, and Alan Lewis is who introduced me to Adam Lambert, because I said, "Who's the best singer that you know?" I said, I think all you guys are the best singers I've ever heard." And who's the best singer that you know to start a band with? And he was telling me about Adam. That's how me and Adam met. Scarlett Cherry was one of the singers. Her name wasn't Scarlett Cherry then, but just Scarlett. I don't even know what her last name was. Doesn't matter anymore. And then, of course, me and Tommy started playing together when he joined Adam's band. It was just like the beginning of everything. We both joined Adam's band at the same time. And he and I are the only ones who are still there, that were there, you know, from day one. And he came down to audition, and the chemistry with me, him, and L'Ingenue was just something that it doesn't happen every day. Something you don't see very often. And we started talking about, he's got all these cool tattoos, and that's how we started talking. We like a lot of the same music. Me, him, and L'Ingenue would get together and just kind of jam just before we were going to kind of get together to start jamming with Adam and playing like Pantera songs and Metallica songs, just to kind of tighten up and kind of get used to playing with each other. So when it came time to play on my own I've always kind of wanted to do some sort of project on my own or start a band. And every time I do that, either, you know, the singer goes off and becomes super famous and it kind of disbands the band, or with everybody's schedules, people go on tour with different people, or, you know, living in LA, you can't just be sitting around. You got to be doing something or playing with somebody. And so it started out. I started playing just solo acoustic shows, and then I was going to start playing with a band. And then, well, before that, Tommy would play with me sometimes. Out doing like open mic nights or whatever. And when I started really taking this project seriously, I started doing open mic nights just to go practice and play in front of people and just to be in an environment that you can't control. And if you could make that work, you could make anything work. So Tommy started playing with me, and then at the beginning of the year, I was going to play out, and Warren was like, "Hey, hit me up, you know, if you need a drummer." And I was like, "Yeah, sure," you know. And so everything just kind of fell into place. I've kind of been looking back, like, how did we all come together? It just all just kind of happened. But everything's been going on in everybody's lives so fast. It's been such a whirlwind that we all like playing, and we all are really good friends, and we all play really well with each other, and there's no drama, and there's no
It's almost been
egos.
2 years.
It's been a long time.
2 years almost.
Yeah. Drama and egos are the number one thing that's going to tear up a band. So I feel like I got a job to do. I want to get people playing music again and excited about playing music, and not everybody. It seems like everything is just conforming to all these. You know, it's like eventually it's just going to be one big company that controls everything, and I want to at least fight a good fight against that. I don't know.
fall in or not, but or at least get people going. This
Right. Our buses were next to each other, and nobody could figure out like which line. And even like one of our old monitor engineers was monitor engineering Interpol. So it was like, you know, total.
I got to go on their bus on accident or whatever.
Like, yeah,
I was
totally
looking for Timmy, and I was like walking around on their bus. But yeah, it was cool. We had a show with Interpol, and then the next night it was like with the National too, which is another really cool.
Oh right,
cool.
Yeah,
it was awesome. Brooklyn. Like we didn't get to see him because it was different.
Yeah, we missed. I don't know if that's a secret. But.
Kind of the same thing, how you could wear a lot of hats at once. You know, he was doing a lot. He was like MDing the Atom tour, and then his wife was about to give birth, and then he had to like be at both places there. And you know, it's like he didn't let it affect either one. He was like there for everything, and it's just like, you know, I respect the passion for what he does with his making this album and everything. He doesn't like let people like hold him back or let him. You know what I mean? It's just kind of, it's cool.
A secret about him is that he loves that song Friday by Rebecca Black. He'll play it here in a second.
I think that
he likes Complete a lot too. This band called Complete.
Who doesn't?
Yeah, I love him too. He turned me on.
I wanted to cover.
I'm a follower.
I really wanted to cover this song, and they refused. I was gonna do it, and then just do this like killer guitar solo, and then with hopes like then we could become. We need something that would make us like a YouTube sensation.
Right.
You know, where everybody will watch us on YouTube.
Yeah, light you on
so
fire.
So if we do that...
He won't let me do it. Like
you can always kiss Xander. I think that was Xander.
That's weird. Would you like one of Monte's kids?
I would like to have a baby like Beatrix. She's cute and fat and chubby and... always smiley. She's adorable. But all of his kids are adorable too, though. Of all of them.
Yeah, we got a lot of cool things going on coming up in the future.
We're going to do sex.
Well, kind of. We're going to do something you don't see bands do a lot of, you know, you don't see people do this a lot, but we're going to do a nude calendar. And it's kind of the first time that a band has done this. Our good friend Lee Cherry is taking the pictures. And he's got, you know, Lee's kind of known for taking these really detailed pictures. And, but what we're going to do is we're going to go to the, we're going to go up into the mountains where it's snowing. And we want to do a picture in the snow. That's, you know, so Tommy wants to do it kind of like standing on a platform in the snow, but I say we stand like in the snow. Because our feet might get kind of cold, but.
I want to be with the animals, like, you know, like. Holding on to, like, hugging a grizzly, but... We want to do that picture with Monty on all fours, and he's got, like, puts his head in the lake and comes out with a fish and just shaking the fish. And it's just going to be like a candid thing. Like
we're gonna do another one. I don't know.
You're my honey bun, sugar plum, pumpkin. You're my sweetie pie. You're my cupcake gumdrop, snickums, bickums. You're the apple of my eye. And I love you so, and I want you to know that I'll always be right here. And I love to sing three songs to you because... You are so dear.